Hello, everyone, and welcome to Verge 20. My name is Shana Rappaport. I am the Vice President and Executive Director of Verge, and I have the pleasure of serving as your host here on the main stage, direct from the GreenBiz office in downtown Oakland, California. There are thousands of people coming together for Verge this week from over 80 countries and representing a huge diversity of industries, sectors, and communities. We are so glad that you're here. Now, before I offer some context about what to expect, I want to talk for a minute about pine cones. Hear me out. You see, I learned something extraordinary about pine cones this year, an already record-breaking year of devastating wildfires here in my beloved home state of California. Now, the thing about pine cones, specifically this one species called serotonous cones, is that they actually rely on the destructive force of fire to create new life. Because what they do, dangling high atop the trees or scattered below on the forest floor, is wait, sometimes for years. And as soon as they feel the fire coming, yet rushing through the canopy on hot winds, they open and drop their seeds. In other words, in the face of an existential threat, what they do is seed the future. And this is what we are here to do together at Verge. Our world is on fire, and our work is to plant the seeds of a new economy, one that is powered by clean and renewable energy, in which our transportation systems are electrified and accessible to all, where we draw down and sequester more carbon than we emit. A world where we leverage the power of technology to restore and regenerate the life support systems of our planet. If this sounds like the future you're working to create, well, then you've come to the right place. But wait, what is this place? I mean, here we are coming together, and yet we are so very, very apart. And I'm not gonna lie, I miss you. I miss the energy of being in community, of bumping elbows in the lunch line with old friends, of the serendipitous moments that lead to new ones. I miss hugs. We're now 8 months into this pandemic, and the losses that we have endured are incalculable, of lives, of jobs, of plans, of the people and places that we love. And yet here we are, thousands of us, not in the same place, but together at the same time. And yes, you're likely balancing the competing demands of hungry children and pets who need walking, and let's be honest, at least 8 other tabs open on your computer. But the opportunity to learn new solutions and forge new relationships here, online, at Verge this week, can plant seeds of a new future. And with that in mind, I'm excited to share with you, to preview just a few of the ways in which we hope to offer you a renewed sense of possibility and community this week. Our keynote program brings you some of the most inspiring leaders that we know at the forefront of advancing systemic and inclusive solutions to our global crises. Lisa Jackson, Bill McKibben, Gina McCarthy, Wade Crowfoot, and so many more. Our 5 concurrent conferences focused on energy, transportation, the circular economy, carbon removal, and our newest addition this year, Verge Food, offer over 150 sessions to go deeper into the technologies, policies, and opportunities within each market. And in the true Verge spirit of convergence, to explore where they all intersect and the spaces in between where breakthrough innovation lies. And the programming we've designed for you is short form and high impact, 28-minute breakouts, just 60 minutes of keynotes each day, and plenty of opportunities to connect with each other. Indeed, Verge is as much about the convergence of people as it is about the convergence of technologies. And we know that connecting with new potential partners and customers and allies is one of the many reasons you choose to be a part of the Verge community. And that's why we've chosen Hopin as our online event platform. All of you are invited to check out the virtual expo over here on the left of your screen, where you can learn about and connect with representatives from leading clean economy companies. And those of you who have all access passes, well, there is so much more. Roundtable discussions, the ability to connect one-on-one, a video networking tool that is surprisingly fun. On that note, please make the most of your experience at Verge and find your kindred souls. If you haven't yet introduced yourself in the chat, please do. I urge you to use the chat this week to ask your questions, to let folks know not just who you are and who you represent, but your asks and your offers. Indeed, thinking back to those serotonous pine cones, what the world needs now are the seeds and solutions that each of you and your organizations bring. What is the story you want to be able to tell about how you met this moment, about what you did in this decisive decade? After all, this is our world and she's on fire, rising more than 2 degrees, planetary emergency. We're living in this world and she's on fire. We must accelerate a clean economy. Oh, it's time we learn to draw down, keep it down in the ground. Oh, fossil fuels gotta go. We gotta hit net zero. Is on fire. This world is on fire. We're walking through fire. This world is on fire. We take, we make, it's time that we everyone's brilliance, build systems of resilience. Can't stand by and let all the species die. Let's learn from the plants and bees, a biodiversity sale. It's time we learn to draw down. Please welcome to the Verge stage, GreenBiz Chairman and Executive Editor Joel McHauer, and Apple's Vice President of Environment, Policy, and Social Initiatives, Lisa Jackson.